Put your hands together, scream as loud as you can. Welcome on stage, the living legend, the Great Dane himself. Welcome, welcome, the man, Peter Schmeichel.
Yeah, thank you very much. I'm really happy. It's my first time in Singapore. I haven't seen much of Singapore as yet, but it looks beautiful. Exactly what people who've been here before told me about the place. And I'm really pleased to be here with Quartz. I think very importantly for me is your Quartz involvement with football. I think that's, I'm a football person. I've been that all my life, and the job you do with the Young Lions, and I'm gonna meet them tomorrow, hopefully help them a little bit. Instruct in science.
You know, we've worked with some of the biggest names in football, not only within the English Premier League, but obviously with Pele and Cantona. Obviously, Eric Cantona. Last year, we had a session with the Quartz Young Lions and a game at Jalan Besar. You know, he was a Manchester United legend. We've worked with other Premier League clubs as well, and we've supported the TV coverage of most of the major tournaments during our promotional campaigns as well. So I think that the general public can see that we're passionate about the sport first, we're passionate about the community first, and you know, we're interested to engage with anybody that is a respected ambassador within the sport.
I think they've done really well. I mean, obviously, when you have that amount of money, you have to do well. I think they've got some fantastic players, but to win the Premier League, it's more than just having good players. It's a process that goes on for 10 months and a bit, and you got to stay on top of yourself for 10 months and a bit. At no point can you switch off. As soon as you do that, and we've seen it right now. And the experience of Manchester United is that they know exactly what happens, once you get to March, once you get to April. And the manager, Sir Alex Ferguson, he's so good at managing his players and his squad throughout the whole period of 10 and a half months. And winning at the same time. And there's not a lot of managers in the Premier League that has that ability. Arsene Wenger's another one. Well, I can tell you this, he's not even thinking about the City game. I think the media are looking at the City game at the Etihad as the deciding match. But he's looking at today. At 8 o'clock tonight, he will play Queen's Park Rangers at Old Trafford. You win that, guys, you're 8 points clear. That's what he's going to say before Man City plays, and then you're going to ask a very big question of Man City. They play a very difficult game. I mean, they can beat Arsenal, of course they can, but Arsenal can beat Man City as well. So by the end of today, if you do your job right, you could stay 8 points or 8 points clear with six games to go. And that's the message he's going to say. Give them. He's not going to look ahead, because he doesn't do that. I think I have to say, I feel that he's been treated very unfairly by the media. Even before he played his first game, they already decided that he was a bad goalkeeper. I think it wasn't right to change between the two goalkeepers all the time, because it didn't help De Gea. But now he's had a very long and consistent run in the team. He showed us that he is very, very capable, and he has saved us points. I mean, at Chelsea, when we came back to 3-0, he saved a fantastic free kick, which would have lost us the game, and that would have lost us 1 point. But today nobody's saying that, and that is testimony to his strength. And if we go on to win it, he's played a major, major part in it. That is a question which there's no answer to it. Because if you asked me 2 years ago, I'd probably say Mourinho, but I wouldn't say Mourinho now. If you asked me today, I'd say something like Guardiola. But if he retires in 5 years, who's to say that Guardiola's the right person? Who's to say he's available? I mean, there's a lot of questions and a lot of ifs. You ask me to come back 13 years after I retire from I honestly, and I can say this very truthfully, I never ever, since I retired, missed playing. I was 40 years of age when I retired, and I've had it. This sounds really bad when I say I've had enough, but I reached the point where it was right for me to retire. And unfortunately for me, I've had a second career, and I'm working with something that I really do enjoy. So I basically never had the opportunity to miss it.
Peter Schmeichel, he's a legend. Go, man, go!